was in the neighborhood, and I had a little gift for you.
Oh. Oh, a cell phone.
Oh, it's not just any cell phone. It's a Joan phone. See, I got one, too. This way we can keep in touch whenever and wherever.
But, Marcus, I've already got your home number, your work number, your cell number, and your pager number.
See, with this phone, when I get a call, I know it's you. Because it's got a special Joan tone.
Oh, that is so, so sweet. Thank you.
So how about lunch? You free?
Oh, no, I can't. We are so swamped here today.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, thanks again. I'll call you later.
Not if I call you first.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh. He gave me a cell phone.
If I'm not mistaken, he gave you a Joan phone.
Get it as soon as they take down the police tape.
Hi, Marcus. Thank you for coming. We need to talk.
Yes, we do.
Yeah, first, about what William told you.
Joan, I know that you're not a man. I'm not an idiot. Although, obviously, you think I am.
No, Marcus, I would never think that.
Joan, you have been playing these juvenile games, and I told you I'm not into that. Sending your friends over to do your dirty work. You want us to be over? We're over. Give me my damn phone back.
Wait a minute. He's breaking up with me? So why is it turning me on? Oh, he is so Denzel in Mo' Better Blues right now.
You know what this means, don't you, baby? I'm going to have to reactivate the Joan phone.
Oh, God, could he just shut up? Marcus, I'm moving to Peru.
You want to break up with me? Fine. I don't need you. Just give me my damn phone back.
That's not gonna work this time.
Well, you can't blame a brother for trying.
Coach Russell, what do you have to say?
Well, Your Honor, I have witnesses. I have witnesses that will prove the whole sordid story about her life. All the destruction, all the devastation caused by my soon-to-be ex-wife.
All right. Now that we understand each other, I want to hear your side of the story, too. Why do you want this divorce, Coach Russell?
Your Honor, she lied to me. Mm-hmm. I mean, she lied about her past.
Yes.
She told me that she was a fine, young, upstanding woman.
That's right. No.
Turned out that she wasn't that at all.
Mm-mm.
Well, when you were dating, didn't you ask to meet her folks?
Yes, I did, Your Honor.
And what did she say?
She said her parents were dead. And none of her family was close.
And you bought that?
Well, Your Honor, my parents were dead, too. And I knew what it felt like for your parents to be dead.
Oh, Daddy.
I didn't want to pressure her. She didn't want to talk about it because I loved her. I trusted her.
Yes, Daddy.
Turned out she wasn't doing nothing but lying between her teeth.
Enough of that!
Liz, there were so many times I just wanted to end it all. Instead, I would drink a lot, take pills, because the pain was just so bad. One time, I cut up my arms pretty badly. Ended up in the ER. That's where I met Eve. She was an intern then, and, I used to give her hell, and she used to give it right back to me. I'll never forget the day that she took her beautiful hands and she just caressed my wounds. Somehow Eve knew my anger and my pain. But what she told me to do, she told me to take that anger and that pain and to funnel it into something that was good. Liz, I did. I became the best damn coach in Harmony. And Eve became my wife. We built a wonderful life together. funny how God works. The worst thing that happened to me, this accident, bought me the best thing that ever happened to me. My lovely Eve. But I could never get over the accident. I could never put it behind me. Until one time I was at the Crane Mansion and I was at Julian's safe and I found a repair bill of his car. Well, at least I think I did.
You aren't sure, TC?
Well, my pop's ghost told me where it was and where to find it. And I did, and then I lost it.
TC, does your father appear to you often?
No. Pop only seems to appear to me when Julian's involved. I don't think that Pop can rest in peace. You know, Liz, it's a good thing that I didn't find that repair bill, because I swear I would have killed Julian. Would have lost everything. I would have lost my wife, my kids, oh, my lovely girls. And I would have went to jail. I would have lost everything, Liz.
I never knew until now just how much you love Eve and how much her love means to you.
I love her so much. But Liz, now you know. You know things that Eve doesn't even know. And please promise me that you won't tell anyone what you saw here.
TC, I won't. I promise.
Eve, we have been married for 20 years. We have been living a lie. Did you think you could keep this secret? That you had a baby with Julian Crane for the rest of your life?
No, but...
Wait a minute. Where the hell is this kid now?
I don't know.
What the hell you mean you don't know? Come on, you know what... Whitney and Simone? Are those Julian's children and not mine?